Where we're at is Standing Rock Sioux Nation, which is located in the middle of America, which is the North and South Dakota, the two Dakotas put together.
The land on Standing Rock varies diversely. The Missouri River, which flows into Lake Oahe, is a big part of the reservation.
We're surrounded by the river, by water, open prairies, nice grass, beautiful, beautiful place to be, beautiful place to grow up. My name is John Pretty Bear. I represent the Standing Rock Sioux Tribe as the Standing Rock Sioux Tribal Representative for the Cannibal District of Standing Rock Sioux Nation.
I'm Lieutenant Commander Cody Wolf. I am currently the Engineer Consultant for Indian Health Service, and I work with the Standing Rock Sioux Tribe.
With IHS, our water system, they go hand in hand, you know, with the helping with the long line users, which means that we can expand our water infrastructure, we can expand our sewer infrastructure.
IHS has been very active on Standing Rock this year and the past years. We just did two major lagoon systems. Along with that, we do a lot of individual water and sewer projects. The construction site in Bullhead, South Dakota, they're just getting started. They had their trench box in the ground and they were exposing the existing sewer main piping that needs replacement. That one lasted 50 years and that was clay tile pipe, which tends to be a lot more brittle than the pipe we're putting in the ground today, which is PVC. And that should have a lifespan of 50 to 100 years in the ground. The project, when it's done, will help the operators for the Standing Rock Sioux Tribe immensely. They've dealt with multiple backups throughout the years, especially in that Bullhead community site where they were at.
I've been involved with this Bullhead project for many years. I was here when they started having the problems when the sewers start backing up into homes. My name is Randez Bailey. I am the MRI OMNR director, and I also am the director for wastewater. On a day-to-day basis, I make sure everything is flowing. The water is flowing, the sewer is flowing throughout the day. I am pleased that IHS was able to help with the replacement of the sewer lines.
So now the system will be, you know, able to provide a nice smooth transition to the collection system, eventually to the treatment system. So it eliminates any backups that may be happening or prevent any other in the future.
You know, I have people coming in and just saying thank you to you and the IHS people for helping. I mean, those are the most satisfying days I can have.
The longevity of the new system can last upwards from 50 years to 80 years.
In our culture, we plan generations ahead. We don't plan for tomorrow, we plan for our grandchildren's grandchildren. So water will always be important to Standing Rock. Water is our livelihood, water is life. So it's very important for us to continue to provide that to our people.
When completed, 89 American Indian homes on the Standing Rock Reservation will benefit from the new sewer mains. Since 1959, the Indian Health Service's Sanitation Facilities Construction Program has led efforts to build and improve water infrastructure in tribal communities like Standing Rock. The IHS estimates that approximately 41,000 American Indian and Alaska Native homes lack adequate sanitation facilities. Of those, approximately 5,200 homes lack access to a safe water supply and/or waste disposal facility. The bipartisan infrastructure law appropriated $3.5 billion over 5 years to the Indian Health Service to improve safe drinking water and waste disposal systems serving American Indian and Alaska Native homes and communities. Produced by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services.